In this video, we'll continue working with coordinate systems and talking about changing coordinate systems. We're going to work with a basis B in this problem that is a basis for the vector space R3. So here is the basis B. It consists of three vectors, the vector 2, 2, 4, the vector minus 1, 0, 3, and the vector 1, 1, 1. And this is a basis for R3 because any vector in R3 we can write as a linear combination of these three vectors. So these three vectors are linearly independent. They span the space R3, and thus, by definition, these three vectors are a basis for R3. So this is the basis we're going to work with. And what we're going to do is we are going to find a matrix called the change of coordinates matrix that lets us go from the coordinate system represented by the basis B to the coordinate system, what I would just call the standard basis. So the standard basis for R3 is just the set of vectors 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So when we don't specify the basis, we just talk about the vector space R3 in general, we always kind of implicitly mean working with what we call the standard basis, where there's a 1 in each entry of the vector. So 1, 0, 0 is the first vector, 0, 1, 0 is the second vector, 0, 0, 1 is the third vector. So there's always a 1 in the ith coordinate of the ith vector. So there's a 1 in the first coordinate of the first vector, a 1 in the second coordinate of the second vector, and a 1 in the third coordinate of the third vector. So in this problem, we're going to find a matrix that lets us go from this coordinate system, where we're writing things as linear combinations of these vectors, to the standard basis for R3. And this is R3. There was a little typo there just a second ago, but I fixed that. So the matrix we want to find, usually when we write this in terms of just mathematical notation, we might call this A, we might call it C, we might call it P. Different books use different things. I'm going to call this a matrix P. And I'm going to use this notation right here to indicate that this matrix P takes me from the basis B to what I call the standard basis S. So this arrow notation means we're going from one coordinate system to the other, the coordinate system defined by B to the coordinate system defined by the standard basis S. So that first part right there indicates the original basis, and the part here to the right of the arrow indicates the final basis that we want to end up with. How do we do this? Well, in general, the equation for this change of coordinates matrix is pretty simple. What you need to do is each column of this matrix, because that's what it is, it's a matrix, is going to be the vector of our original basis. So B1 is this vector, B2 is this vector, and B3 is this vector. So we need to take all of those vectors and we need to write them with respect to the basis we want to go to. In this problem, since the basis that we want to go to is the basis S, I put a subscript S right there to indicate that I need to write the vector B1 in the coordinate system defined by the basis S, or the standard basis. So that's the first column. The second column is B2 written in terms of the basis we want to end up in. And then the last column is B3 written with respect to the basis that we want to end up with. So in general, the general form of this change of coordinates matrix always looks like this. You just stack up your vectors, but you write them in the coordinate system that you want to end up in. All right. So let's think about that. What is B1 with respect to the standard basis? Well, this vector right here is B1, and it's already written with respect to the standard basis. 2, 2, 4, by definition, is written with respect to the standard basis. So filling this in is pretty easy. It's just B1. Same thing for B2. This vector right here, minus 1, 0, 3, is already a vector written with respect to the standard basis. When we write down this vector, we know that this means minus 1 times 1, 0, 0, plus 0 times 0, 1, 0, plus 3 times the vector 0, 0, 1. That's what this notation right here means by definition. So for this particular problem, since we're going from a basis B to the standard basis, since we're going to the standard basis, this part of the problem that we're working right here is almost trivial because we were already given the vectors B1, B2, and B3 written in terms of the standard basis. So this problem's kind of easy, actually, kind of boring. We'll do a more complicated one here in the next example. So because of the certain circumstances here, and we're actually going to the standard basis, this step is actually really easy. It's very simple for this example because the BIs are already written in terms of the final basis. In general, though, it would be more complicated if we wanted to go, say, from a basis B to a basis A, where A was not the standard basis. So what is this going to look like in terms of the matrix? B1 is just the vector 2, 2, 4. B2 is just the vector minus 1, 0, 3. And B3 is the vector 1, 1, 1. So I claim that this is the change of coordinates matrix that will let me take any vector written with respect to the basis B, multiply it by this change of coordinates matrix, and end up in the standard basis. So let's do a little example. And this example is from the previous video when we were doing some change of coordinates and representation work. We had a vector x written with respect to the basis B, and its coordinates in the B basis were minus 1, 1, 5. And we figured out that in terms of the standard basis, the vector x had representation 2, 3, 4. So this is something that we worked previously. We figured this out. What we should be able to do now is to use this change of coordinates matrix to do the exact same type of computation. So I'm going to write down the change of coordinate matrix that takes me from basis B to S. And if I multiply this by the vector in the B basis, I should end up with the vector in the standard basis, because that's what this transformation does. It takes me from B to S. So let's go ahead and write down the change of coordinates matrix. Let's write down the vector written in coordinate system with respect to the basis B. If I actually perform this multiplication, what should happen is I should end up with the vector 2, 3, 4, because that's what this operation should do for me. Well, let's see if that really happens. Let's go ahead and multiply all this out and see if that's what I get. So in the first coordinate, I'm going to get 2 times negative 1. I'm sorry, 2 times a negative 1 is a negative 2. And then a negative 1 times 1 gives me a negative 1. And then 1 times 5 gives me plus 5. So that is the first entry. And then we do the same thing for the second entry. We'll take this row times this column, do that dot product. So that should give us minus 2 plus 0 plus 5. And then for the final entry, it's this row times that column. So that should give us a negative 4 plus 3 plus 5. And if we add all this up, guess what I get? I get 2, and I get 3, and I get 4. So the change of coordinates matrix works just like we think it should. We kind of tested it with this little example. We were able to take a vector written with respect to the basis B. We operated it on it by this change of coordinates matrix, and we ended up with a vector in the standard basis, and the vector we ended up with matched our previous computation just as we expected. In the next problem, we'll work an example where we change from a basis to another basis that isn't the standard basis, and that problem will be a little bit more complicated, a little bit more interesting.